Introductions real quick. Are we doing introductions in the small groups, Katie?
We can. I did go ahead and have requests that people put in the chat just in case, just for the sake of time. So I'm going to leave that one up to you. Do you want to go ahead and go around?
I mean, we can do it real quick. So your name and what is your cheap, easy, quick meal besides peanut butter and jelly? Okay. Joey Lightner, Quinoa Bowl. Chelsea?
Hi, everyone. Chelsea Blakemore with Platte County Health Department. I would say an easy meal would be peanut butter on a tortilla with taco chips.
Mariana?
Mariana Hengler, Jackson County Health Department. I'm going to say one of the bagged salads that has all the great flavors, and then throw on some type of chicken or salmon or some type of protein.
Sandra?
Hi, I'm Sandy from Johnson County WIC. My quick meal is, it's called French chicken. I usually use brown rice. I make brown rice, and you just throw chicken breasts in a 9x13 pan with French dressing and Lipton onion soup mix. Add a little steamed broccoli. That's my deal.
Sounds delicious. It sounds hot too. And I'm like, I can't do the heat. Always hot. Simone?
Good morning. It's afternoon now. Simone Taylor. I am with HHS in OASH. You all's meals sound really healthy. I just like to make my own like soup out of wontons from Trader Joe's.
That's where it's at. Teresa?
Hi. I'm a nurse, partially retired, and health educator now at Clay County Public Health Center. I would agree with Mariana. I always have salad fixins, and I cook up lots of chicken and turkey and fish ahead of time and throw that in for some protein or cottage cheese and good to go.
All right, Shelley. It always takes people a minute to hit the mute button on like your phone. I don't know if you're around, Shelley. Move to Natalie. Dun, dun, dun. Go ahead, Natalie. Oh, she's connected. How about Bonnie?
Hi, I'm Bonnie, a nurse up here at Mercer County Health Department. I like a bowl of Lucky Charms, but if I'm trying to be healthy, I throw a salad in. So that's about it. Thank you.
Katie, do you want to say yours?
So I told Lightner earlier, I just like to do frittatas. I think they're really simple to make. Delicious, full of protein and vegetables.
Do you want Natalie to pop into your camera? So, because she can't turn on her mic, right?
Correct.
Oh, okay, Shelley.
Yeah, I wonder. Let me put my headphones on.
Just give your name and then your favorite easy meal.
My name is Natalie, and I guess I do cheap pan salmon and broccoli.
Yeah, where it's at. Totally. Okay, I think that's everybody. I didn't miss anybody, did I?
Nope.
So Katie, I think the show is yours, right?
Yes, with
okay, can you guys hear me? Okay, perfect. I'm gonna share my screen really quick again, and we're gonna go over the agenda. So we have a lot to cover today. And it's okay if we don't get to everything, but we already went through welcomes. I'm gonna do a quick Mentimeter. We are going to rank overall national strategies. It's kind of different than what we did last month, where it was kind of just asking if it's important for Kansas City, is it easy to implement, and I'll give her a refresher when we get there. And then we'll cover what the next couple of months or our next couple of meetings look like. And then we'll go ahead and we'll prioritize our strategies. And then just as a reminder, we meet the third Thursday of every month. So our next meeting will be Thursday, April 20th at 12 p.m. And I will go ahead and drop that in the chat if you want to register now. Okay. So we're going to do the Mentimeter. So if you could pull out your phone, you can either scan the QR code or you can go to menti.com. Go ahead and use the voting code 4786-1972. I'll also go ahead and drop a link in the chat. I'm gonna give everybody just a moment. If you wanna hit that thumbs up, let me know you've entered into the Mentimeter. And if you're having difficulties, let me know too, and I'll try and help navigate you through that. Okay. Is everybody logged on? Cool, I'm gonna go ahead and move on to the next slide. Okay, so the question is, what role can public health professionals or organizations play in promoting physical activity? Deliver programming, lead coalitions. And you should be able to type more than one answer if you've got, you know, more than one thing that you think is important and you want to share. We said partners. Perfect. Data, connecting resources, accurate information, family activities. These are all really great. And these are things that I want us to keep in the back of our mind as we move forward with this group. I'm gonna go ahead and move on. So what we're gonna do now is something that we were supposed to do last month and I forgot to put it up, so I apologize. So we're gonna just go ahead and do it quickly. What we're going to do is we're going to rank the strategies. There are six of them. And as a refresher, strategies represent a set of choices used to achieve an overall objective. Strategies are useful in defining long-term objectives and planning for how to meet those goals. So right now we're focused on the public health strategies that are based off of the National Physical Activity Plan. So strategies should be over on the right-hand side of your screen. And what I want you to do is rank them based off of what you think is most important or relevant to Kansas City.
Katie, can we just review these strategies real quick? Because I have to review them myself.
Yeah, that would be great.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Oh, I said just take a moment. I'll let you go ahead and jump in.
Okay, so I'm just gonna like talk aloud. And if I'm wrong here, Robin or anybody else, stop me and happy to. So strategy one is really about like public health workforce, right? So maintain a workforce competent in physical activity, et cetera, et cetera. Number two is really about like coalitions and partnerships in order to implement evidence-based strategies. Number three is really about policy development and advocacy. Number four is monitoring of policy and environment. So this is like surveillance data, like those kind of things, right? Number five is disseminating tools and resources for physical activity. And number six is money, funding, right? I have that right on it from everybody's perspective.
you summarized that up very well.
Now I have to figure out how I want to, I don't know. Katie, I'm sorry. When we're talking about ranking these strategies, what are we're ranking them based on, we're just ranking them.
The mute button. We're ranking them based off their importance related to Kansas City. So like how likely are we to implement this first strategy, the second strategy? And this will make more sense when we move on to the next portion, which we'll get to. I'm gonna just give it 20 more seconds and wait for one or two more people to go ahead and finish voting. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and stop sharing. And kind of the next thing on our agenda was just kind of review the timeline for how the rest of our meetings will look like. So today what we're going to do is we're going to prioritize these strategies. We're going to discuss them a little more in depth. And hey, Robin.
Go ahead, you can finish. I just had a question.
Oh, okay. And yeah, feel free to jump in too. I know you've done this step before with mass media and sports. So, but we're going to go a little more in depth. We're gonna discuss some of the barriers to implementing some of these strategies and who's missing from the table and how just overall we can move forward and which strategies we wanna focus on first. Robin, go ahead.
Yeah, so I was just, were you gonna go over those results? Are we gonna have a chat about them or is that later? Or?
So just from what I'm following, how some of the other sectors have done it, they posted the results in Mural. And so I figured we'd go over the results in Mural. If you wanna go over the results right now, I can go ahead and pull those up though.
No, I'm just like, when will that happen? Is that today?
Do you mean of the individual strategy rankings?
Yeah.
It can be. I was going to do Mural.
Why don't we just go back to that real quick, just and see if people have any comments on it.
Yeah, absolutely. Let me go ahead and share my screen again. So,
yeah, this is interesting, right?
Yeah.
What do you guys think about this?
Oh, I'm gonna lower my hand. Sorry. But then I'll just say, I like that the public health we should have them give out money. Do they have money to give out?
What kind of public health are we talking? I think I think what I was basing, like there's two pieces here. It's the organization and the agency and the differences in those. And I'm not sure if the strategy was intentional with that language. I'm kind of assuming they were, or the strategies were. And I always think the agency being, at least in this instance, the agency being health departments. And so from a health department stance, just thinking about, like, I ranked 5 actually on the lower end of things. I thought that what our, just thinking about our involvement and ability, it's looking at those like strategy 4 and 3 around like that monitoring, that kind of maybe not necessarily like fully engaged piece with individuals, but really looking at kind of that more like higher level bird's eye view of what's going on. The rest, besides 5 being slightly on the lower end, I'd say the rest of it kind of ranked pretty similar or kind of followed in line with what I was thinking. So I don't know if Chelsea, being another health department, if there's thoughts on that or.
I mean, I was kind of, I mean, when you talk about funding, I mean, it's always funding because, you know, have a lot of funding with the health department. So I actually put number 6 kind of at the top end, just because we kind of work with what we have, and we have grants that are kind of focusing on other things other than physical activity. So if we had some sort of monetary anything, we could definitely push that a little bit more. And I kind of agree with Mariana too. If we don't have funding, that's fine. We can still do the work, but then it would be more of strategy 3 and 4 without funding. Does that make sense?
What do others think?
I personally think that our collaborative partners in our different communities, in Clay County, we have 6 municipalities that we try to work with all of them in some fashion. But it really stands out to me in the communities and municipalities where we have strong relationships with a lot of the other heavy hitters. It makes it so much easier. And Excelsior Springs is probably one of our most diverse, needy communities. But let me tell you, when I go to some of those meetings, you see such an excellent cross-section of partners at the table. You see law enforcement, you see housing authority, you see seniors, you see people from the churches, the hospital is right there in the middle of it. So I think that that is key to really getting movement and getting things done. And the community center is another huge partner.
Yeah, that's great input. Simone, I'm really interested. So you and I both worked at KCMO for a minute, or probably a while, and then aren't there anymore. What do you think about all this?
I mean, my top strategy was 5 as well. I don't know that at the time that I was there that we had a lot of focus on physical activity. And so I do think it's something as a public health entity that we should probably allocate, you know, not only attention to, but some funding just so that you can have the ability to have actual initiative around physical activity. And it's something that is, I mean, obviously we're talking about it, but I think it's something that is kind of top of mind for people along with, you know, some other things. But there's just not a lot of really solid initiative and funding, I think, to kind of back up what we know is needed.
Well, and your funding kind of comments make me think about number 1, right? Like maintaining, developing and maintaining a workforce competent in physical activity, which is last on the list. What do you guys think about that?
You know, I don't know that, I guess my thought is that maybe there isn't a public health workforce per se around physical activity, but there is a workforce, right? And so I think that if we, that goes back to kind of that partnership piece, if we had funding or good partnership, then I think there are folks who could help us in that space to help us, you know, lead these initiatives. So I don't even know if that is necessarily the issue. They aren't public health folks, but they exist. And so we need to have a better way to connect those folks and be able to support the work that they're doing in community.
That's so interesting, Simone, because I was thinking, I wasn't thinking like that, but that's a really good point. Shelley?
So my question about that is, which comes first, the chicken or the egg? Does the staffing come first or does the funding come first to pay for the staffing? And I will also say, I had someone from a local health department reach out to me about a funding opportunity that's coming down from the CDC. And the details aren't important, but part of the conversation was that person shared they really could use a physical, an expert in, or somebody with experience in physical activity as a staff person at the health department to help inform. They were specifically referring to their CHIP. And if physical activity is one of the key treatments for chronic disease reduction, then shouldn't health departments have at least someone with experience and or expertise in that area? So again, just a few comments and some recent experiences.
I was actually going to jump in and say I was surprised that strategy number one was last. But I know it, something has to be last on the list, but I was kind of surprised that it was the last one. But yeah, I think as far as like a hierarchy of needs, I think the funding might need to be found or created before. I don't know, maybe there's funding there and I don't know about it, but yeah, the funding might need to be there before developing a task for a workforce.
Sandy and others, I'm curious, if somebody like the physical activity plan were to go after some funding, do you think the health departments would sign on if they could get like a staff member paid for?
I mean, I know I work in community health at Johnson County. I think we would be good for that. I mean, I'm not somebody who's actually in charge of those things, for but sure, yeah. I think it would be a something that would be interesting to the directors and things. So,
okay, Robin.
I just had a question about that strategy one, about the workforce. So obviously people can go and get a degree in something related to physical activity. But if someone doesn't do that, and there's a lot of reasons you wouldn't do that, I'm only aware of one, like, training course for professionals to learn about physical activity and public health. And I'll throw it in the chat in a second because I know that everyone on my team has gone to it, but that's the only one I've heard of. So maybe are there other opportunities out there if someone, you know, wants to, you know, go to a weekend course or something like that to learn more about physical activity?
Yeah, I mean, I'd be interested if anybody knows of anybody else, anything else. Yeah.
Yeah. So just like as we, you know, these discussions are great because you can kind of think about, oh, you know, maybe that's a need then, right? And, you know, that's where strategy and tactic development is important. So.
And I think
I threw in the chat the link to the one that is put on by the CDC that Katie's gone to, I've gone to, Shelley's gone to, and we all love it. So.
Well, and I think that brings me back to Simone's point of like, you know, maybe the physical activity workforce is in partnership with public health, not part of public health, right? And so maybe it's not housed at the health department. And I think there's especially in Kansas City, a weird kind of diverse, big metro sprawling city like Kansas City, the expertise is not just in physical activity. It's also in like culture, in place, in like those kind of things. Cause the same people who deliver physical activity in Johnson County are not the same folks to deliver in Wyandotte, right? And it's like 5 minutes apart, you know? Sorry, Katie, I kind of took over and I know we got a lot to do. So I'm gonna turn it back over to you and Robin to like move us forward.
Yeah, you're good. I just need to change my screens. That was a good discussion. Oh goodness. Okay. Okay, can everyone see my screen? Perfect. I know this looks terrifying. This is my first time using it, so bear with me while we kind of navigate this together. But kind of what we're gonna do today is that we're gonna use this platform to work together. It's a shared space called Mural, and I'm going to go ahead and post the link in the chat. This will allow us all to work within the same room, see what everybody else is seeing. So I'm going to continue to explain a little more while everyone logs on. But you're going to be entered in as a visitor and we shouldn't be able to see your name. You're going to just be like some kind of random animal. And you're going to be able to navigate kind of like I would, and I'll go through some of these different control settings. If you're on your phone, that's okay too. If you don't want to contribute, as in like you don't want to type or like use this setting, that's okay, just let me know. And if you want to go ahead and either type in the chat or speak up, I can take your place and navigate for you. Like I said, we're gonna work in this space. Essentially what we're gonna do is we're going to start in this left-hand corner, and then we're gonna work our way down. And then we're gonna come back over here, which we may not get to today. And what's great about what we just did is we kind of already just talked about this. So that'll kind of alleviate a little bit. Robin? You're on mute.
Do we need to register for this? I'm having to
You should.
Maybe I'm doing something wrong then.
Yeah, so I sent you, I don't know if you're using the link from the first agenda I sent you. I updated that link because I realized I had the wrong one, but I'll go ahead and, if you actually check in the chat, that link is a visitor link, so it should work. Okay. Okay, so essentially we're starting here and then we're gonna go over here. This is called a PIC chart. And it stands for Possible Implement Challenge in Kibosh. I think I said that right. I don't know if anybody else has heard of this. I actually haven't. But it's been used in the past for some of our sectors to kind of like discuss if some of these strategies are easy or will, if they have a high impact, and whether or not they're easy or hard to implement. And so like I said, this is what we just did today. It's kind of some of the strategies that we it's all the strategies that we just ranked. And if you can't see these strategies, by the way, you'll notice that they're also over on the right hand side. I'm gonna go over controls really quick because I know that some of you probably still can't see this very well. So if you look over on the right-hand side of your screen, you're going to notice that you've got these navigation settings. So if you're on a desktop like me, you're going to go to mouse settings. So that allows you to zoom in using your mouse wheel. And then you can navigate around this using your clicker. If you're on an iPad, you're going to go ahead and use the trackpad mode. So I'll give everybody a second to go ahead and switch their settings that's appropriate for their desk or their computer and play around with that a little.
I think we're pretty good, right? Everybody seems to be in here moving around and stuff. Cool.
Explain the picture. So some considerations before we proceed on the next step is while we use this mural application, we're going to all be working in the same document. There's a lot going on. Just make sure you're not adjusting what other people are typing or saying or dragging and dropping them. Please work only with your own responses. And then the second thing is that if you were on a laptop and you're going to, oh, I already went over the setting. Cool. I'm following my step-by-step instructions for how to use this. So with that being said, it does look like everybody's on this document. So we can start with strategy one. So what you're going to do is you're going to grab this circle and right over here, let me readjust the screen. You're going to grab this circle starting with strategy one. And based on its impact for Kansas City, low to high, and then its difficulty in implementing within Kansas City. So this would be easiest to hardest. You're going to place your strategy one, and we'll start strategy one, we'll move to strategy two. And then after all of that, what I'll do is that I'll move this sticky note kind of where the average responses are, but I'll do that at the end and I'll have you guys help me with that step. And I know this is a lot, so if you have questions, please let me know, but we'll go ahead. I'll let you guys move these circles based off the strategies. And so again, if you can't see it, use your Zoom function. You should be able to see on your screen, however is easiest for you. And there should be enough dots for everybody.
I can't move the dot.
Yeah, I can't either, Katie. That's what I was saying. It's still asking to sign up.
Okay, well, this was helpful. I thought I fixed this. Apologies, give me just a moment. And thank you for bearing with me. Like I said, this is my first time using this.
Yeah, I think we all have view only access, right? In the top left-hand corner. Mine says view only.
I apologize. Can you guys give me just one moment?
So while she's getting these settings figured out, if you want, you can kind of scroll up to those strategy rankings. And I don't know if we had any more we wanted to say about some of these rankings, or if, and we've done this before in other settings too, we've done like initial rankings and then we talk about it and people say, exactly what we were saying before, and we're like, I didn't vote for five because of this or that. If we want to, we can, you know, this is not written in stone, it's written in, you know, ones and zeros. And so we can redo this if after talking about it, people are like, oh, that's a great point about strategy one. So any other comments about this prioritization exercise?
I have a couple comments, Robin. So, and please anybody jump in here and interrupt me, especially if I'm not getting this right. But like, I get the sense that 4 and 3 are really the top two. Am I wrong? I don't know how the computer like ranks it, but like I would put 4 and 3 as like capable things that like health department staff can do.
I think, yeah, I have a question, I guess, with this sector and with, I know the last meeting there were some more agencies or organizations that were maybe not health departments. And so is this sector going to mostly be health departments? Is that kind of the goal? And if so, I would think, like, just thinking about our capacities and like what Jackson County 4 and 3 is where we currently have the support. We don't have the workforce, you know, that would be something that we'd have to do first or get the funding first. So I guess that's 2 points. One, is this more departments? And then if that question is yes, then I would agree with you that for me, 4 and 3 would be there.
Well, Mariana, I think that's a great point. And I would be interested in what other people think about that.
I would have to agree because we, at our health department, we kind of rely on our partners to provide more like interventions, like holding classes and things like that. We would promote that. And if they need any additional assistance, like we would help where we can. But I agree with Mariana that 3 and 4, I believe, would probably be our capacity on where we would be able to help the most. But if it is more programming and out in the community and things like that, we can do that at some extent, but not probably as great as you would want.
So I've got, these are great questions. I don't have an answer to them. I am thinking, just because I know what's coming ahead, that, and you can kind of see it, it looks like the mural page is getting reloaded while she adjusts the settings. But a future step is to rank each of the strategies more specifically about how important is this, period. How likely is this to happen in the next 3 to 5 years? How likely is this happening in the next 10 years? And so there could be things that we all say is like, this strategy is the most important thing to do. At the same time, there is no chance that it's going to happen because of, you know, all these other things. So it's a good discussion of how we should kind of think about these questions. My kind of initial thought would be, assuming that there are no restrictions and we live in a utopia, what is most important? And then you kind of address through these pick charts and through the other specific rankings, you know, like, oh, but maybe these others are more important because of the reality of reality. So, thoughts on that?
I do think Mariana's point, though, of like, you know, is this health department focused or is it public health systems, like, you know, the larger public health thing focused? I think that's a good point, because I think that then, I think to Robin's point of like, is this important, like yes or no, is a community answer. I mean, to me, I don't know if that's like right. But you know what I'm saying? Like, will it work or, yeah, I don't know, whatever. And then who can do it is the second piece of that, right? And like public health as a whole can do any of these things, right? Health departments may only be able to like partner if there's funding, like be a pass-through organization for funding, like you know, those, am I, what's your guys' reaction to that stuff?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's kind of where, I mean, yeah, I think that is probably pretty similar to what we'd say too. And I know kind of in the push for a lot of public health departments, and I think we are trying to get there too, is to really kind of think about those systems and those kind of higher upstream things. And so putting more emphasis into the surveillance that we can do, into the policy work that we can connect to data. And so I think that called to me in three and four, strategy three and four as being my top two as well, because we are, with our capacities, we are trying to push a little bit more those ways, because then we can, if we can provide the surveillance on, you know, on physical activity, on outcomes, region wide or metro wide, jurisdiction wide, that can help the focus of other of those programmatic type of things. So that's kind of how we're moving. And so I think that, and trying, we have a policy team that's just getting started as well. And so kind of looking at within our, what we can do, which is still limited in the world of being a state or a local health department, but you know, what can we, what types of like policy solutions can we connect to the surveillance, to the data, things like that. So
Katie, whenever, if you do have an answer, if you got that stuff figured out, let us, interrupt us and stop, but I'm gonna keep going with this.
No, keep going. We'll go ahead and we'll do this next month.
Okay. Hey, so I mean, Robin and everybody else, I think that I'm getting the sense that the public, this sector, public health, is much different than the other sectors, because, you know, we're not, the public health departments are not the folks that like deliver interventions that often, right? They do like, they do this, the systems coordination level piece, and then they farm everything else out to the intervention staff, to the clinicians, to the, I mean, that's what Casey Mo does, right?
I can speak for Clay County Public Health Center because I've been here a long time. I've been here 18 years, and I can tell you that during COVID, I think we work closely with our daycares, and the impact on daycares, in fact, that's our focus area for our maternal child health contract, is with daycares on healthy nutrition and physical activity. And I can tell you, half of the daycares I worked with went belly up during COVID. The ones that remained, they had to completely redesign, even though the majority of their families had been families that they had had their kiddos for years. It was just, people got so mean-spirited about everything. And I think you had a lot of people who loved doing childcare who got out of that. So the daycares are still hurting for proper staff. And it's not just with the daycares. I'm noticing with a lot of my community partners since COVID, a lot of people that were anywhere close to retiring or were new to whatever they were doing, and they didn't like the way things turned out during COVID. They saw the ugly part of working with the public a lot of times. So I think it's like we're having to rebuild a lot of relationships that we may have had for years with a lot of our collaborative partners, because there's new staff in all of those areas. So that is the huge, I would say, challenge that I'm seeing that is so, so different than it has been in the past.
So not only is this not, we're not the clinicians, right? The public health departments, we're not necessarily the clinicians or the interventionists, right? And the partnerships that we've had in the past that we've like relied on for a long time are maybe either weaker or non-existent.
Exactly.
Yeah, I think to Teresa's point, when, you know, I worked on our CHIP previously, and at, yeah, relationships, whether they were strained or just there's been, you know, the great resignation, all of those things that have happened to all of us. And for a couple of years, we weren't relying on those programmatic things. We were kind of heads down in COVID. And so definitely been working on rebuilding relationships, those programmatic type things. I think we're still trying to claw out of COVID and say, like, what can we do with you post COVID? And I think to your point, Joey, about as far as like the program piece and the interventions, I think in public health, we have done that historically. And I think that we're just, I think, realizing capacities and other organizations who may have the time and energy to do them better. And so where can we kind of move our focus to be a little bit outside of that intervention or direct intervention? And so that's kind of how we're shifting and have been shifting for a few years, I'd say.
And I think it's better, right? I mean, public health works. So I have an intervention that delivers physical activity programming via like fitness professionals on the east side. So they have relationships with people in the community. They know how to get people out and recruit. They are part of that community, right? They deliver culturally appropriate physical activity styles, right? I can't do that. And if I can like do the money piece and like see if it works, like that's my role. And that's, you know, as a white public health guy, you know? So, and it's better, right? So that's an interesting, I don't know if Robin, I'm really interested in what Robin and Shelley are thinking as we're moving through this.
Well, one thing I was just going to share, and I know you may have mentioned this before, but we model what we're doing locally on the national plan. It's just a model, so it's just a starting point. So I was just going to share, and I showed it just briefly, but I'll share what the national plan. Are you seeing my screen? Public health. Okay, so this is the formal definition of who is involved in public health. Public health sector consists of government organizations such as public health agencies and federal, state, county, and local health departments. It also includes non-governmental organizations that seek to address public health goals, such as institutions of higher education, professional societies, nonprofit organizations, think tanks, and advocacy groups. So that's a starting point in terms of how you want to think about this. We can do whatever we want here. That's perfectly fine. My only smart comment on any of this is not my own comment. It is from someone who I did my training under, and he would go out to other organizations like the Department of Transportation or early childhood centers or things like that. And he would say, he would start every single talk that he gave, he said, "You are a public health practitioner." And I was like, oh, that is great. You know, that it makes it inclusive to everyone, like you guys have all been saying, to the people on the ground interacting with the community. So that's about all, only thing insightful I have to say on that.
Yeah, so like priority one, right? The public health workforce. So I think we as a group have to decide what that means, right? If we're talking about, you know, the capacity, how do I say, the expertise within local health departments to do XYZ, or are we including, you know, like fitness professionals or, you know, other folks on the ground who are actually, you know, implementing interventions. So we have 5 minutes left. I think we should talk about next steps. So next time we'll do the, I want to call it like a weakness strategy, like weakness strengths. SWOT. It's like a SWOT analysis, right? Essentially, kind of, yeah. So next time we'll do that. And then what else, Katie?
That might be all we get to. It's the process. I'm not going to lie. Yeah. And then moving forward after that. Well, within that process, we need to decide, are we keeping all the strategies? Do we need to alter them to be more specific to Kansas City? And then after that, the following meeting, which will be May, hopefully, will rank our tactics and hopefully we can get to prioritization. The thing with that is that there are 56 tactics for the public health sector based on the national plan. Just a heads up. So it might take us a while. So if we want to meet more than once during that month, we can. That's something we should discuss so that we can just get it off our plate, or if we want to make it a longer meeting.
I mean, I don't know how everybody else feels about this. I like doing this work and I also like getting stuff done, right? I like both the sides of the coin. And so like, this is really valuable to me to like kind of set the stage and move forward. But in shorter than longer time, you know what I'm saying? Like in the next like 3 to 6 months, I would like to see some kind of like, what does this mean for Kansas City? What does a project look like? How do we get that up and like running, right? And so I don't know how everyone else feels about that. Chelsea's shaking her head like, yes, let's get moving.
Yeah, I think, let's knock it out. I don't mind meeting more than once a month. I don't mind a little bit longer meetings. I'm kind of with you, Joey. Like, let's get to work. Let's get going.
Perfect. Yeah, okay. At the end of the day, you know, we want it to be meaningful for the group, you know, and some groups that we've had, they've taken like a year just because that's the pace they wanted to move and things like that. Others, it took like 2 months. So, you know, it's whatever the group, you know, kind of feels is necessary to really kind of understand what we're trying to do and or what the group wants to do. So,
and I'm happy doing a little homework. And so if there's 56 strategies and I need to like sit down and think about it before a meeting while I'm like eating lunch, I'm happy to do that. I don't know. I think everybody else, you know, we're all pretty invested in this work. Shelley's comment makes sense too. A couple longer meetings might be appropriate.
I will just say, don't get the 50s, how many of our tactics will fly through that. I mean, the work happens on the strategies and the tactics. It goes super, super fast. Trust me.
Well, so our next meeting is supposed to be April 20th. Would we like to go ahead and extend that by 30 minutes? So make it until 1:30, so 12 to 1:30.
I'm happy to do that, or I'm happy to do the opposite too. I find that like 30 minute meetings are very valuable because you can get in and get out, right? Like get it done, you know, do what you need to do and then move forward. And if there is like a problem or something, then like we have a week or, you know, however long to solve it before, so that like we don't waste, you know, 30 minutes or something. But I'm happy to do either. I don't know what other folks think, but we have a minute to decide. Why don't we do this? Why don't, for next time, let's do an hour and a half, and then we'll figure out how to move forward from there.
Yeah. And Joey, you and I can get together too and kind of discuss how to proceed with the group.
Cool. All right. Last word. Go ahead.
No, that's it.
Last words from anybody? Have a great Thursday. We'll see you next month. And Katie, give us some homework in between.
Yeah. Keep an eye out for the newsletter because I'll probably put it in that. Okay. Perfect. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.